Thank you for joining us at 6 tonight. I'm Julie Montanaro.
And I'm Jacob Murphy. That video from February 2022 shows an officer allowed a city commissioner's aide to leave the scene after he admitted to driving while intoxicated.
The state attorney tells WCTV he would have prosecuted that case, but it never reached his desk. Our Capital City correspondent Matt Hoffman is live in the studio this afternoon. Matt, question, why is this coming out now, and what did the aide tell you?
Yeah, good evening, Julie. Now, this occurred back in February of 2022, but it was only recently released by self-described center-right outlet, The Capitolist, just a few days before the 2024 election. Now, the subject of the video, Ryan Ray, is an aide to Tallahassee City Commissioner Jeremy Matlow and the head of Leon County's Democratic Party. Ray tells us this occurred before he became sober and before he became the chair of the Leon County Democrats.
Where's your house? Where's your house at, man?
That's body camera video from a TPD officer who encountered Ray on February 8th, 2022. The video starts with the officer approaching a car with Ray behind the wheel. He knocks on the window to wake him up. Even though the officer assumed Ray was intoxicated, he let him go.
How do you think Mr. Matlow would feel if he came here and he saw that you were sitting here in front of Circle K, drunk, sitting in your car? Do you think he would like that? No, he would absolutely not like that.
We reviewed the Tallahassee Police Department's policy on impaired driving enforcement. The document requires officers to perform field sobriety tests when they have reasonable suspicion that someone is a drunk driver. But Ray is allowed to leave after his girlfriend arrives on scene.
If I were to catch you driving on this road, you could absolutely have killed somebody. Do you understand how irresponsible that is? I'm going to give you a little bit of this because I'm not going to take you to jail or anything.
The officer confirms that Ray drove his car from the Governor's Club downtown to a Circle K steps away from TPD headquarters. Ultimately, he says Ray will not be going to jail.
Jail, so it's not like I'm trying to incriminate you or anything. Do you think it was wise to drive all the way down here from Governor's Club? No, absolutely not.
Tallahassee-based attorney Fred Conrad specializes in DUI cases. He says it's not 100% clear if the officer broke policy, though as a citizen, he would have expected the police to do more. And he says he's had clients arrested for less. Conrad says the main issue is determining whether or not this was a good use of the officer's discretion.
Now, here is part of a statement from State Attorney Jack Campbell. He says, quote, "Law enforcement has great discretion on how they act. I'm not going to second guess their job. However, if this office had been referred such a case, we would have prosecuted it aggressively. Drunk drivers in Tallahassee should expect to go to jail in such situations in the future." Now, here's a statement by Ray. He said, quote, "I've grown a great deal since this incident almost 3 years ago. Sobriety has improved my life immeasurably, and I'm grateful for the support of so many dear friends and allies." Now, here's another look at what TPD officers are supposed to do. This is straight from their own policies. The first step is determining whether the person was driving under the influence, then conducting a field sobriety test if the officer has reasonable suspicion. Finally, officers are directed to use discretion and cite the driver or release them with a verbal warning. Now, according to our local prosecutor, the statute of limitations is over, meaning Ray can no longer be charged for this incident. We reached out to TPD for comment on this story, and we have not heard back. It's unclear whether there'll be any internal review of the officer's decision to let Ray go. If you'd like to watch that video in full, we have a link for you right now, WCTV.tv. All right, Matt, thanks so much.